The Tiny PlayStation 5 was a project that reduced the size of the original PS5 by 60%. This was accomplished with a custom cooling solution and various 3D printed parts to squeeze it into the 3.3-liter SkyReach 4 Tiny. The cooling wasn't better than a stock PS5, but it only ran a few degrees hotter at half the size. The only problem with the Tiny PS5 was related to the power supply, but I'll tell you more about that later. When the PS5 Pro was announced, I started working on a design with the intention of making it smaller. I wanted to make a premium case from scratch, and I didn't want to wait for the launch of the PS5 Pro. So I used parts from the Tiny PS5 to make a prototype to test the modifications and unique features I had planned to use. Unfortunately, I didn't purchase a PS5 Pro. I was pouring money and resources into other projects like Erebus, and couldn't justify the price. This 6-liter prototype has unique features that enhance the cooling, portability, improves the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and gives it a clean and premium look. The chassis and wraparound bezel are made from aluminum with a Cerakote finish, and dark smoke acrylic panels allow you to see inside the system. The top panel has cutouts for the spring-loaded power and eject buttons and USB ports. It's attached with 4 embedded magnets that makes it easy to clean the heatsink and fans. The cooling system uses the same heatsink plates used in the Tiny PS5. The Alpenfone Blackridge CPU cooler now has 2 120mm slim Noctua fans and a push-pull configuration. It rests within a shroud that pulls cold air through the back of the system. Hot air is ejected out the side of the case using 3 60mm slim Noctua fans set inside a recessed pocket handle. The pocket handle sits flush with the side of the case and is made from polished aluminum. It makes it easy to carry the system as is or to remove from a bag when traveling. The system LED is tucked inside the pocket handle with the 3D printed light diffuser to create a subtle glow. The stock PS5 Wi-Fi and Bluetooth antenna were mounted internally, but that was a problem for this build since the metal case caused lag and connection issues. I swapped the original Bluetooth antenna for this external pair and mounted them to the rear panel. They could be folded away or removed when traveling with the system. The Wi-Fi antenna was mounted internally at the top of the system, just beneath the acrylic panel. The biggest limitation of the Tiny PS5 was the additional storage. It couldn't use a full-size 2280 M.2 drive. It relied on shorter 2230 M.2 drives that are more expensive and top out at 2 TB. I used this M.2 extension cable and mounted it to a 3D printed bracket so that I can install this 4 TB M.2 drive with an attached heatsink. The final change involves the external disk drive. I was able to make one smaller than the previous version used with the Tiny PS5, but I rarely used it and kept it stored away to reduce clutter. The PS5 will not complete system updates if it isn't plugged in, so my original intention of using it only when I needed it wasn't practical. I decided to turn the system into a digital variant. There are 2 ways that this can be accomplished. The hardest method involves removing the fan power header, the disk drive cable connector, and the BIOS chip from the motherboard. Next, you have to reprogram the BIOS chip, or you can buy a BIOS chip that has already been reprogrammed. After that, you have to re-solder the BIOS chip to the motherboard. That sounds like a great time with the soldering iron, but I think I'll take the easiest option, which involves removing the disk drive control board and mounting it inside the case. If you keep the power and data cables connected to the disk drive control board, then the system doesn't care if the mechanical parts of the optical drive are broken or even missing. I created a 3D printed bracket to mount it to the rear of the motherboard. Finally, to align with the darker titanium and black color scheme of the build, I made a new controller charging dock that uses the same parts from the Tiny PS5 charging dock. It uses magnetic pogo connectors for the power cable and has a thick steel plate bottom for increased stability. Remember the power issue I mentioned before? I started to experience random shutdowns with a few of the latest graphics intensive games. I knew that the system wasn't overheating, because I have a thermal probe monitoring the temperature at all times, and I never saw the overheat warning pop up on screen. So, I dusted off the kilowatt meter, embedded a thermal probe in the stock PS5 heatsink, and started doing some testing. For whatever reason, Sony doesn't provide a way to monitor the system thermals or fan speed. To accurately measure the APU temperature, I need to use a thermal probe. I can't put a probe directly between the APU die and heatsink without negatively affecting thermal performance. The next best option for accurate readings is to drill a small hole in the base of the heatsink above the APU to embed the probe. Both heatsinks are different, so I did my best to place them in the same position and distance relative to the center of the APU. I used Expedition 33 as a benchmark with graphic settings at quality, motion blur off, and film grain off. The stock PS5 consistently pulled 230 to 235 watts, and the temperature averaged 59 degrees Celsius. The Tiny PS5 pulled 220 to 225 watts, and the temperature averaged 56 degrees Celsius. Now this is where things got interesting. I found the cooling performance of the Tiny PS5 to be underwhelming. I was confident that it should be cooling better than it was. Out of curiosity, I removed the top panel with the game still running, and the temperature drop was substantial. It was obvious that the airflow through the cold air intake was too restrictive. I reworked the design and 3D printed a new shroud with a slightly larger intake and deep channels around the fan. It consists of four parts that are glued together and slides over the heatsink. It has a neoprene gasket that presses against the cover panel to prevent recirculation of hot air. This also meant that I had to make a new acrylic cover panel and rear I/O cover plate. I decided to remove the eject button since it was no longer necessary, and 3D printed a new bracket for it. I created a new Wi-Fi antenna housing that installs on the interior side panel, and 3D printed the I/O cover plate instead of cutting a new one from carbon fiber. The test results after these changes are incredible. The Tiny PS5 average temperature is 50 degrees Celsius, and the power draw dropped below 220 watts. I would love to know what the APU clock speeds are doing at any given time, but Sony doesn't provide an option to monitor that either. Based solely on the gaming experience, it does seem to run smoother, which tells me that the clock speeds are probably higher on average, since I no longer notice frame drops associated with thermal throttling. The stock PS5 power supply is rated for more than 350 watts, but I believe that the Platinum Rated 250 watt GAN would work well, and it did, until now. The latest games are pushing the PS5 harder and power draw is increasing. The robust 250 watt GAN just isn't enough anymore. So I replaced it with the 500 watt GAN and the random shutdowns disappeared completely. Now maybe I just have a potato PS5, but there are a lot of PS5 mods on YouTube that use a 250 watt GAN. They either don't have this issue or they just aren't telling anyone about it. The PlayStation 5 is quickly approaching its 5-year anniversary. This project is very late to the party. And even though I have no intention of making another one, I wanted to share it with you. It was a great test platform for some of the design features that I wanted to try, like the cold air intake, hot air exhaust through the baffled pocket handle, the thick wraparound bezel, and the transition from disc to digital. I'm going to share these files on the NFC Patreon in case you want to make one yourself. Sony has made several models of the PS5 since launch, and making a mod for each would be exhausting. Therefore, these files are only compatible with the 1215A model. I've tweaked the design so that you can have the aluminum parts made with a service like SendCutSend and 3D print the rest. I made a mounting bracket that will allow you to use the Black Ridge CPU cooler instead of the heatsink plates that I used, but you will need to purchase additional hardware and small heatsinks like these for the RAM and MOSFETs. This mod is very complex, and you will need soldering skills and a lot of patience. If you want to support the channel, then please leave a like, comment, share, or subscribe. Better yet, join the NFC Patreon. Follow the links below to our Discord community and our store page. Thank you for your time and support.
Nothing.